Are we in a new space race with China? The current NASA administrator, Jim Bridenstine, doesn't think so. He has been quoted as saying, "That race is over. We went to the moon and we won. It's done." But even he has publicly recognized that China is making enormous strides. In a tweet on January 2nd, he congratulated China on the first ever successful lunar landing on the far side of the moon, calling it, quote, "a first for humanity and an impressive accomplishment." Some American officials, however, see China's lunar landing and other aspects of its space program as alarming rather than awesome. Vice President Mike Pence, for instance, said that China's landing on the far side of the moon, quote, "revealed China's ambition to seize the lunar strategic high ground and become the world's preeminent spacefaring nation." He also accused China, along with Russia, of developing military technologies like anti-satellite weaponry. So clearly, depending on your perspective, China's space development is either awesome or alarming, or both. In any case, there is no doubt that China is racing to catch up with the US space program. Let's review how fast China's space program has developed, and look ahead at some of the goals that Beijing has set. China's space program was actually founded in the same decade as NASA, the 1950s, but suffered a huge setback with the man-made disasters of famine and political chaos during the years when Mao Zedong led China. The first Chinese satellite didn't reach orbit until 1970, 1 year after Apollo 11 landed on the moon. Around the turn of the century, China's space program finally kicked into high gear. Since 2003, when astronaut Yang Liwei became the first Chinese person to go to space, China has sent 11 different astronauts into orbit, including the first female Chinese astronaut, Liu Yang, in 2012. In 2018, China conducted 39 orbital launches, more than any other country in the world. The US was second, with 34 launches. However, it should be noted that China's annual budget for its space program is actually very modest, at only $5.8 billion, whereas NASA has a budget of $40.9 billion. So what's next? China has big plans for the moon. The aforementioned lunar landing program is well developed and has been a focus of public attention and national pride in recent years. The program is named Chang'e, after a goddess in Chinese mythology who lives on the moon. In an online poll, Chinese citizens chose the name Yu Tu, or Jade Rabbit, for the lunar rovers that have twice accompanied the Chang'e landers. Yu Tu also happens to be the name of a mythical creature who is the pet of Chang'e. Beijing aims to build a, quote, "lunar palace," or research station, on the moon about a decade from now. Officials in Beijing have also projected a booming $10 trillion economic sector to develop around the moon by mid-century, and have dubbed this the Cislunar Economic Zone. Beyond the moon, Beijing has its eyes on Mars. If China and the US both meet their goals for 2020, China will become the second country to land and operate a spacecraft on Mars, while NASA will land its fifth rover on the Red Planet. Finally, China is building space stations. China has tested a couple of small space labs in recent years in preparation for a full China space station to enter orbit by 2022. The CSS will be about one-fifth the size of the International Space Station, but it will serve a very similar purpose, hosting international teams of astronauts to do scientific experiments. Some of the experiments the CSS already has planned range from studies on fire and fluid behavior to the effects of radiation in space on DNA. The main difference with the ISS is that on the CSS, very few, if any, of the astronauts and scientists involved will be American. As one last note, China does have a private space industry that is just starting to take off. But before 2014, this industry was off limits for private investment in China. So space startups in China, like iSpace, LandSpace, and OneSpace, have a long way to go to catch up with their American counterparts, like SpaceX and Blue Origin. In short, China's space program is taking off, though the US retains a huge first mover advantage, a bigger budget, and a much better developed private space industry that will ensure the basic balance of power in outer space is unlikely to change in the next decade. If we're in a space race, it is only just now starting and has a long way to play out before a, quote, "winner" is decided.